Our Across the Aisle segment tonight, a shocking new video shows Planned Parenthood abortionists joking about killing babies. But who is facing the repercussions for the video? Well, not the abortionists, it's the journalists who recorded the video. Now California Attorney General, who, by the way, is on Planned Parenthood's payroll, he's threatening to throw the filmmaker in jail. Watch.
The heads that get stuck that we can't get out. The hemorrhages that we manage, you know, those are all parts of our experience. But there's no real good place for us to share those.
The fetus is a tough little object, and taking it apart.
Wow.
On day one. Yeah. Is very difficult, but...
Oh my God, I get it. When the skull is broken, that's really sharp. I get it. I understand why people are talking about getting that skull out at Calvaria.
You know, sometimes she'll tell me she wants a brain and we'll, you know, leave the calvarium until last and try to basically take it or actually, you know, catch everything and keep it separate from the rest of the tissue so it doesn't get lost.
An eyeball just fell down into my lap and that is gross.
But we do intact DNA, so.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay.
If I'm doing a procedure and I'm seeing that I'm in fear of that it's about to come to the umbilicus,
uh-huh.
I might ask for a second set of forceps.
Uh-huh.
Pull the body at the cervix and pull off the tip.
Oh, so yeah, okay.
So it's not...
Right.
Yeah.
See,
given that we actually see that it is the same way, and given that we might actually both agree that there's violence in here, ask me why I come to work every day. Let's just give them all the violence
as
a person is killing. Let's just give them all that.
Well,
that kind of
surgery. You go in there and you go, am I getting the uterus or the fetus? Oh, good, fetus. What have I got? Nothing. Let's try again.
With me now, former Georgia State Representative, Democratic strategist LaDawn Jones. LaDawn, good to see you.
Thanks for having me again, Liz.
All right, thanks for talking about this topic, too. I know this is not an easy topic. I appreciate you being willing to talk about it. You and I have had some very fruitful conversations, I think, about life issues, about abortion, and about being pro-life versus being pro-abortion. I think this is the next stage in it. I want to ask you, one of the lines in this video, I mean, the whole thing is troubling start to finish, but one of the lines comes from one of the abortionists, and she says, let's give them all that. Let's give it to them. It's violence. It's killing. It's a person. LaDawn, what do you make of that?
You know, I really can't trust that video, Liz. That same video was used in a case in Texas as well as California. And the court in Texas determined that that video was so horribly edited and so much cut out that you can't really determine what the full context of the conversation. This is medical speak between doctors talking to other doctors and practitioners about if you look at a process that... It sounds very clinical, and so I would not want to judge the entirety of Planned Parenthood based on that one clip.
No, and I mean, you don't have to, but just this isolated incident, I mean, do you disagree? I mean, it was an abortionist. I don't think really taking it out of context, that sentence, I mean, in and of itself, it's pretty horrifying. Let's give it to them. It's killing. It's violence. It's a person. Or we can even go to another example if you're more comfortable with that. The example about the eyeball. I mean, she was talking about a human eyeball, the eyeball of a baby falling into her lap. And I mean, I've heard the argument, oh, it's a doctor. They talk about their patients in gruesome or grisly ways. It's not respectful. I know they do it. I have friends that are in the medical profession as well. But talking about an eyeball falling into the lap of the abortionist, I mean, I don't know how there can be any argument that that's not a human being.
So whether or not as a human being goes against the entire discussion about Planned Parenthood and the services that they provide, right? Planned Parenthood is not making the policy or religious decision on whether or not this is a human being. What they are doing is seeing a patient who has decided on their own accord to terminate a pregnancy. And as a result of that, Planned Parenthood and their doctors are acting in accordance.
Sure.
And apparently, sometimes what happens is that a child's limb or the fetus's limb, I should say, something happens to it. Again, we cannot judge.
Right, but you and I right now, neither you and I are representing Planned Parenthood. Perhaps what they're doing, performing abortions, is illegal. I think there are two examples of illegal behavior in these videos. But for the sake of argument here, let's talk about, you know, whether or not this is a child, whether or not this graphic language from the abortionist, this clinical language, if you will, to use your term, doesn't that give you pause and say, you know, regardless of what you feel about Planned Parenthood, whether they're being legal or illegal, doesn't that, as a woman, as someone who's carried children or who might carry children in the future, as someone who's advocated for abortion, doesn't that give you pause that abortion might be ending the life of a human being?
Unfortunately, it doesn't. And I'll tell you why. Because as a mother of two children and understanding the process that it takes to carry a child to term, and then when the child actually comes out, feeding and clothing and caring for that child, I could not imagine as a woman telling another woman that you have to go through these processes, which you know that you are not prepared for, and you have an opportunity right now to make a decision to prevent bringing up a child in poverty. Now, I'll tell you.
No, I get that. Forgive me for interrupting. I get that. I get that argument, and that would be a perfectly valid argument. I'd get on board with that if I had proof that there wasn't another life inside the woman. If this were a matter of just a woman with a tumor or a parasite, if it was just about one person, that's a perfectly valid argument. What I'm asking is, when does that argument become invalid? When does the argument that it's just the woman's choice, that it only impacts the woman, that it's only impacting one person, when does that become invalid if we know that it's actually ending the life of a second person?
For me, when that argument changes, if we had a country that when that child came out, that child would be provided for, loved, and able to be in a happy home with food, with health care, and with all the things that they need, then and only then could I say and stand on the side with many conservatives and say, I'm sorry, lady, you lay down, you got pregnant, you're going to carry this baby to term, but don't worry, when that baby comes out, we will have a place for that child. That child will be well taken care of. Until we can say that in that country, I dare not tell another woman what she would have to do for the next 18 years having to care for a child when the Republicans and Donald Trump's most recent budget is cutting out all the services.
Wait a second. But isn't that the same argument? If you're not even arguing that it's not a child, if you're just arguing that this woman shouldn't be forced to take care of a child for 18 years or isn't financially stable, which, by the way, I think women underestimate themselves and Democrats insult women by telling them they're not capable of, you know, rising to this challenge. But using that argument, wouldn't it then, going down the road, make it, you know, a Democratic argument to say, well, that 7-year-old, that 8-year-old, they're being raised in poverty, they have no parents, they have no health care, they're starving, there are a lot of children in need. Maybe it's just better to do, you know, a post-pregnancy abortion and get rid of them. It's a life we're talking about.
Well, actually, Democrats make a similar argument to that all the time. We argue every single day that our government should help those who are least in need so that we don't have to have these discussions, so that women don't have to make these difficult issues. But for some reason, the Republicans won't hear us out when we say we need health care for everyone.
Well, that's all. Do you want me to tell you why? Can I tell you why we don't hear Democrats out when they say, oh, we stand for women's health care, we champion women's health? Because every year, 500,000 little girls, women, are aborted before they have a chance to even make these choices for themselves. Why should I sit here and believe Planned Parenthood when they're talking about what's best for women when they perform 323,000 abortions every year out of the million abortions in our country? That's two victims, the woman and the unborn baby. You can't have it both ways.
Well, this is America. You know, if we were in a country where they were doing genital mutilization that they do that is forced on children and young girls at an early age, then you and I would be together on this. If abortions were being forced on people, but these are people who are grown, who know their circumstances, who are making decisions that are in the best interest of themselves and for the potentially unborn child. And I cannot be the person to second guess what decisions they make. Even if I want to argue that that fetus is a child, I understand what it takes to go to take care of a child. And until we do better by all of our citizens that are born, I cannot force a woman to have a citizen that is unborn.
And see, that I guess that's where we're different, because maybe you and I agree that we need to stand up for the, you know, something like 500 or 5,000, 500,000 little girls and women who are subject to, who suffer female genital mutilation. But I think even more than that, we need to stand up for these little girls who are victims, who have no voice, who are alive inside their mothers and have no opportunity to pursue life, liberty, or property or happiness or anything in our Constitution because they're aborted and feminists don't stand up for them. But LaDawn, thank you for coming on the show. It was great to talk to you.